Hello, welcome to this review of Doodle Maker. First thing I'm going to do is sign in. So when you sign in, you land at this page, which is homepage, and it's just got news that never really gets updated. What I'm going to do today is I'm going to talk about Doodle Maker, why I think it's good, and more importantly, why I think it's bad. Now, you might disagree with why I think it's bad, and you might just see the good in it, but it's become a really polar piece of software. Had I reviewed this last week, I would have said it's all good and I probably would have given it 4 stars out of 5. This week, because I found an issue, I would give it a lower mark, but we'll talk about that in a moment. You can get rid of this if you want, but you might as well keep it up. You've got lots of things down this side. The main thing is your projects, really. These other things aren't that important. Now, I will say I have the Deluxe version, and we'll talk more about what you get in the Deluxe version later. And I do want to say this is roughly $47 for the basic version, and then there's a small upgrade to go to Deluxe version. So if you want to get Doodle Maker, it costs $67, but of course you can get 18 off, which is going to take it to $49. I think that's a fair price, and it comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you can try it out. And it is a good piece of software, and we're going to look at why it's a good piece of software now. So we're back in Doodle Maker, and the first thing you're going to want to do is click Create a Project. So you can use a ready-made template, you can start from scratch, or you can import a video, and it will apparently build slides, but I don't think this is very good. The ready-made templates, I don't think are very good. I generally build mine from scratch, but we're going to look at the ready-made templates. So they're like all these pieces of software, and I have reviewed quite a lot of these types of software. They're niche-based, and I never find a niche that I can fit into. So if we look at this one, car dealership, let's have a look what's made with the car dealership. Okay, so you get the idea. You can make better than that yourself. So that's what I mean about the templates aren't that good. I don't really think they're that good. They save you time. You'd have to pick the specific one for you. And I don't know that there are enough ones to cover everyone. So if we go back to my projects, you can see I've done a lot of videos here. I've got 3 pages of videos. And I use these for making short little ads for Facebook, short little ads for Twitter to promote my podcast. So let's look at this one. I'm going to go to edit here. So this is just to promote my recent episode, episode 131. Yes, I've made that many episodes. And I'm going to click on preview so you can see what it does. The preview is a little bit slow to generate. So what's really good about this is it doesn't take very long to put together. It looks pretty good. It's a very small file size to download and then upload. And you can also add speech and sound to this really easily. So you wouldn't have been able to hear this when I showed it because I've got my microphone plugged in, which means I don't really end up recording system audio. But we had music playing. You also wouldn't have been able to hear that I had someone reading out. So we can add text for people to read out. You can upload your own voice or you can record a voiceover, but by far the easiest thing to do is to type in what you want to say and then click save text and then pick from the TTS, which is text to speech voices. So I'm going to obviously pick an English one, but you can go and change the language if you want. I generally pick English male. I find that's the best, but you can have ones with accents. You can also change your language. You can change the speed if you think it goes very fast or very slow, or you want it to slow down. So that's really good. And you can test out your speech here. So that's really good. So we can insert elements. So this is text, and I'm just going to click off it. If I want to insert text, I click here and I type the text out here. I can pick different fonts, but I think Prime is the best. Change the size. Type my text out here. For some reason, I need to click this box, which I never used to. And then I click insert and it goes in the middle. Now I can move it round. I can readjust it and it readjusts flawlessly. I guess it's a vector. So yep, it readjusts flawlessly and I can move it around. And so what I can do is I can change the transition here. So I can have hand drawing. Those tend to get a bit boring. So I generally have a slide in as well. So I might slide in from the left with a hand. I can change the palette here. We'll keep it black. And I can change the speed of the transition. I normally have it about 1 second. And of course, you can stack things by moving them backwards, which doesn't seem to work, or moving it forwards. I don't know why that's not working, but doesn't work. So if I preview this now, what I'm going to do as well is I'm going to just move it to the top. It's the eighth one to come in. So I'm going to click here and unlock this timeline, and I'm going to move this all the way up to the top, reset the timeline, and I'm going to click preview. What's useful is it gives you your talk duration and your drawing duration, which is useful. So you can see hands are drawing stuff, but my one slid in. So let's just watch that again. Watch it slide in from the left. Okay, so I'm going to get rid of that. And it just tells me the voice and the drawing are not equal there. So that's really useful. But what I can do as well is I can change the language here and I can do some auto translation. I've never used this feature. And I can import a variety of different icons. So you can upload your own ones or you can search for things. Now there are loads of icons and it's good that you can search. So I might want to do fairgrounds. No icons for that. I might want to do subscribe. And we've got buttons. So again, I just click and it's here. I can reposition it, I can resize it, etc. I've got icon, I've got icon find, I've got assets, I've got characters. It's very difficult to know what to search for. So if I search for a dentist, oh, something comes up, that's quite useful. I can upload, I can search Pixabay, photo bin, whatever jump story is, I don't know. So I've got access to loads and loads of icons and assets, and they're all free, which is really good. I can change my style of hand. I generally have this one or that one, but I can change the style of hand, which is useful. So you can add a soundtrack and you just pick it, pick whichever one you want, and you can preview it. Now, what's really good is that obviously I picked a soundtrack that's 1 minute 50 seconds, but this is only about 14 seconds. It's the program stops wherever you get to. So it doesn't go on for another 1 minute 36, which is really useful. So it knows when to stop. And I don't think I mentioned that this is a web application. So what that means is you can use it on any device. I use it quite a lot on a Chromebook, which is really, really useful. I guess you could use it on a tablet, but I've not tried. So we've got backgrounds. Now, I generally use the whiteboard, but you can change it to a blackboard. You can change it to a glass board, is just the other way around. You can change it to its own color, or you can use an image. That's really good as well. You can add in a watermark. Now, I've never been able to get a watermark to work. So I've uploaded a logo and it normally puts a watermark there and you can move it about, but it hasn't always worked brilliantly. And then we've got settings, which don't really do very much, the settings. So when we're ready, we click create video and it will take you back to your projects page and you'll see sort of a circle go around, and then when it's ready, you can download it. Now, if you buy the Deluxe Edition, you get more assets and you get priority rendering, but I did not notice a difference between priority rendering and not priority rendering. It seemed to take just as long. So I've made some great little videos, and you can see some of those as I'm talking. I made some great little clips and they worked really well on Twitter and they worked really well on Facebook. They look really professional. They sound really good. I don't have to record a voiceover because I can just do text to speech. So it means you can generate them really quickly. So for that, I would give this, you know, 4 stars out of 5. It does have its issues. It is a bit fiddly. And I'm going to go back here and talk about some of the issues. So you can add slides. Fantastic. You can add as many slides as you want. But you can't reorder the slides, which is a bit of a pain. Sometimes you can add an asset and it comes across in the wrong color, or it doesn't quite scale very well. So if I search for SoundCloud, I need to go to Icon Finder. But if I search for SoundCloud, I've got all these SoundCloud graphics, which is fantastic. But if I use this one, that doesn't quite look how it did in the picture. And if I expand it, it's not really that good. So some of the assets are really good. Some of them aren't so good. So if I were to do SoundCloud, this one would probably be better for SoundCloud. The bars are much better. Again, let's pick SoundCloud. I don't know why that's so small. I mean, well, that's ridiculous. I've got to make it incredibly big just to get it to a suitable size. But there have been times when I've used coloured ones and they've come out black and they haven't reproduced the way they should. So that can happen. There's also no alignment tools, which is a shame. Now, I was talking about alignment. There's no way other than sort of just judging by eye to align these. It'd be really good if there are some alignment text. The rendering for the file sizes you get, it does take a very long time. There's no way to change the frame rates used. There's no copy and paste. You can't favorite your assets, the ones you use a lot. You've just got to go and search for them and remember their name. There's no keyboard shortcuts, and the previewing takes a long time. But if we look past those for $47 or $49, then this is a great piece of software for what it does. It's a lot cheaper than the alternative software, and it does pretty much the same. But, and there's a big but, and this is why I would downgrade my opinion of it. You'll notice here, there's no download button. And there's no download button because there's an error. And this is an unfixable error. So I made this, and I've got loads of slides, and I spent ages getting things where I wanted them. This is for another channel. So all these slides work. But when I get to, I think, the eighth slide, there's an error on it. Let's have a look. Yeah, there's an error. Current slide has some error. Please contact support team. So I can't go and do anything. All I can do is click OK. Takes me back to my project. So there's an error on it, and it means if I clicked to create the video, it would spin around forever and it never makes the video available for download. So I'm a bit stuck now. I put all this effort in. I can't go and delete this slide because when I click on it, that comes up. I can delete other slides. So if I go to slide 9, this is just another slide I added. I can add here and I can delete here, and that will get rid of it. I can't reorder the slides, as I've said before, but I'm stuck on this problem. So I can't fix it myself. It says contact support. When you contact support, they say, right, we can fix it, but we need your login details. We need your email and your password, and we'll go in and fix it for you. Now, I'm not going to give my email and my password over to a support team, even if they do own the software. I'm not going to give that information out. Maybe you will give that information out. Maybe you're fine giving that information out, but I'm not happy to give that information out. And therefore, all that time I spent making this, I would have to go and give out my password to get it fixed, and I'm not going to do that. So that's a wasted effort. That's massively changed how I look at this piece of software now, and it has left a sour taste in my mouth. I'm not very happy with it, and I will be considering whether I get a refund or not. So let's talk about the things down the side. I've got Deluxe. And what does Deluxe give you? Gives you a template every month. I'm not bothered about that. Gives you more voices. I only ever use one voice. Gives you more background files. Gives you more characters. This video script's not going to use that. You get priority VIP rendering. As I've said, I didn't notice a difference at all. And you get software updates. So you can probably get away with not getting the Deluxe version. There's this thing called white label. What you can do is you can set up a brand and you can go and sell to other people Doodle Maker under your own branding. I haven't used this yet, so I can't talk about it. But equally, now that I've found this problem that your slides don't work under certain conditions and you can't solve it unless you get the support team to log in someone's login credentials, I'm not sure I'd want to sell this, because if they encounter that problem, I would have to ask them for the same thing and pass it on to a third party. I'm not really happy to do that. You've got Toon Video here, and all Toon Video is just another way to make these animated explainer videos. Now, interestingly, I have done a review of that, and if it's published now, you can connect to it in the card. here is a client engine, and I haven't bought this. I don't know what it is, but it's another thing they sell you. And here are some training videos. It's good that you can access them in-app, and they are fairly useful. Frequently asked questions section and the email address for support. So that is Doodle Maker in a nutshell. As long as you don't get any errors, it's a very good piece of software. But once you get an error, you're going to have to give over your login credentials to get it resolved, which is not for me. But I've been making loads and loads of really short, really engaging little explainer videos or clip videos or question videos that have been sort of under 20 seconds. This is such a good piece of software for making that, because you can make them incredibly quickly. It's cheap. You can churn them out really quickly. You've got sound. You've got a voice you can add to it. You can do voiceovers. You've got loads of assets. I don't know where they come from, but you've got loads of assets. There are problems with this piece of software. Some assets not reproducing properly, some appearing different on screen to how they do in the search. Just annoying things like you can't reorder the slides, you can't do any alignments, there are no alignment tools, rendering takes a long time. But they're minor niggles, so I would give this 4 stars out of 5, but because of the issue where there's a problem on the slide and you can't resolve it yourself, I think I'd probably give this 2 out of 5, because that is a big issue for me. Let me know what you think though. Would you buy Doodle Maker based on the review I've given? Is the privacy issue enough to put you off as well? Do let me know in the comments below, and do check out my other videos about these type of softwares. Thank you. Goodbye.